हैप्पी इंडिपेंडेंस डे टू ऑल। आई रूपाली स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास 9th हूँ। मैं आप सभी को स्वतंत्रता दिवस की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं देती हूँ। 15 अगस्त भारतीय इतिहास का सबसे महत्वपूर्ण स्वर्णिम दिवस है। आज हम सभी इस महापर्व को मनाने के लिए जिस उमंग एवं उत्साह के साथ एकत्रित इस रमय भूमि पर एकत्रित हुए हैं, इसके लिए मैं आप सभी का शुक्रिया करती हूँ। 15 अगस्त के इस शुभ अवसर पर मैं आप सभी को एक कविता सुनाना चाहूँगी जो हमारे अंगरक्षक हमारे सैनिक भाइयों पर आधारित है। तो शुरू करते हैं। बुझा है जिस आंगन का चिराग, उस घर की दीवारें भी रोई होंगी। खोया है जिन माओं ने लाल अपना, ना जाने वो माँ कैसे सोई होंगी। कचरा कचरा बहे खून का अब, आखिर हिसाब देगा कौन। क्यों ना भड़के मेरे सीने में भी आग, आखिर कब तक रहेगा कोई मौन। मेरा सीना दर्द से तब जकड़े जब कोई सैनिक का कॉलर पकड़े। ईमान धर्म कुछ बाकी नहीं, क्यों नहीं आपदा में अकड़े। उम्मीद के दामन धोता हूँ जब मैं मायूसी में खोता हूँ। मैं उर्चित नमन करूँ उनका उनको जिनकी निगरानी में मैं सोता हूँ। थैंक यू।
Fort Cleric puts the case file of Bhagat Singh and Big Gadad for bombing at Central Assembly. Mr. Robert start their argument in front of Mr. William. Mr. Robert, Your Honor, they threw bombs in Central Assembly and they also murdered a British officer. They must be...
Mr. Asif Ali, what is your argument in defense?
My clients belonging to Hindustan Socialist Republican Association. They want a free India. The bomb were smoke bombs. Nobody at the site was killed or injured. They just wanted to give a message to quiet India. They have not done any crime. This is a false case against my clients.
Mr. Robert, do you have any proof?
Yes, Mr. Williams. But for that, I have to invite...
Whom would you like to invite?
Bhagat Singh.
The court invite Bhagat Singh. The court allows you to invite Bhagat Singh.
Thanks, Your Honor. Bhagat Singh enters proudly. Were you present there, Bhagat Singh?
Yes, I was there.
Did you throw bombs?
Yes, I did it.
Why did you do so?
We threw the bombs in the Central Legislative Assembly to make the deaf hear, and our leaflet describe the reason for our act.
What do you want to say, Mr. Asif Ali?
They are Indians and want to free India from the British government. This is a part of Free India movement. They did not do any serious crime. I know what you are thinking, Your Honor.
Your Honor, they have accepted their crimes. They must be punished. They are terrorists and they raise their voice against British government. They are not freedom fighters. They are criminals. They must be punished for what they did.
Do not make the mistake to call him a terrorist.
They are not less than a terrorist.
If they are terrorists, then the whole British Empire are not less than a terrorist.
Mind your words, Asif Ali.
I am done with my case. You're
all. Ali, do you want to say something? After listening both sides, my decision is that Bhagat Singh and BK Dutt to be hanged on 23rd March. Bhagat Singh, as you are hero of your nation, I will like ask your last wish.
Even the whole British Empire cannot fulfill my wish because I want freedom for my country.
Any others?
No.
On 23rd March, around 7:33 p.m., Bhagat Singh was hacked, but he's still alive in our hearts. I would like to end the play with the slogan Jai Bhagat Jai.
Hello, my name is Shruti Gupta. I studied in 9th standard of Rukmini Devi Jabira Public School. Today, it's our 74th Independence Day. So let's remember those who sacrificed their own life for only one cause, independence of India and its people, and lead us to face this day. India's freedom struggle had seen many freedom fighters over the years, and the name of Rani Lakshmibai sparks out among them. Lakshmibai was the Rani of princely state of Jhansi and was a brave, fearless woman who fought against Britishers very courageously and eventually lost her life in the revolt of 1857 in Gwalior. She was born on 19th November 1828 in Varanasi to a Maharashtrian parents, Moropan Tambe and Bhagirathi Bai. Lakshmibai was initially named as Manikarnika and Manu nicknamed as by her parents. She lost her mother at the age of 4 and was raised by her father who worked at the Peshwa's court. The Peshwa was very fond of little Manikarnika and used to call her Chabili, which means playful. She was also trained for shooting, archery, horse riding, sword fighting, self-defense, etc. In 1842, she was married to the Maharaj of Jhansi Gangadhar Rao Navelkar and later afterwards renamed as Lakshmi. In 1851, the couple had a baby named Damodar Rao, but unfortunately he died only after 4 months. Then they adopted a son of their cousin named as Anand Rao and renamed as Damodar Rao. The Raja died in 1853 and the British officers under Governor General Lord Dalhousie refused to recognize the adopted son as the legal heir of the king and to annex the state of Jhansi. In 1854, they seized the state of Jhansi and ordered Rani Lakshmibai to leave the place by giving her the pension of ₹60,000. Rani moved to a new place known as Rani Mahal and began securing her position and formed an army of both men and women. The revolt of 1857 started for freedom and Rani Lakshmibai also took part in the revolt and joined the forces of Satyadrota. On 17 June 1858, near the Phoolbagh in Gwalior, the British troops fought against Indian troops, which was being commanded by Rani Lakshmibai. She was dressed as a man, completely armed in horseback with her infant son tied on her back, and began attacking on Britishers. The Britishers attacked from back and she was grievously wounded. So she didn't want to leave her body to be captured by Britishers. She told